After over 10 months and 9 rounds of talks with the Taliban, the top U.S. negotiator briefs Afghan officials on a draft peace accord, a deal negotiated without the involvement of the Afghan government.
For us, a meaningful peace, or a path to a meaningful peace, is the end of violence and a direct negotiation with the Taliban.
Under the draft agreement, the U.S. would withdraw 5,000 of its some 14,000 troops and close 5 of its military bases, all within 5 months of the deal's signing. In exchange, the Taliban would ensure that militants like Al-Qaeda and the Islamic State group not use Afghanistan as a base to launch attacks abroad. The deal is not a ceasefire. According to the U.S., that's the Afghan government's job to negotiate in their own talks with the Taliban, set to take place in Norway in the coming weeks. The process could see the Taliban return to a role in the country's leadership, a prospect some civilians are wary of.
I don't know how to trust them. Lower-level Taliban members say they don't want peace, but here they are talking about it.
Throughout the peace talks and with Afghanistan's presidential election slated for the end of September, the Taliban has stepped up their violence. They carried out deadly assaults on 2 cities over the weekend, and just hours after the deal was presented on Monday, they targeted a compound that houses aid groups and international organizations.